All right, back to my little happy internet machine here. One of those last videos I was talking about the grim mergers, and it is kind of an exciting direction for a moment when you think about going back to older businesses, businesses that have ceased, are no longer in action. They don't even have employees any longer, and yet they're still kind of there with the family. Like the family, maybe the children just didn't follow suit in the business, and they're like there with the items. You know, like let's say you invented an incredible swirl machine on ice cream, but the children that you had never wanted. And since that person has died, and so they're stuck with this swirly machine. So my point is you would tr is grouping mergers of these old grim businesses, because we're talking deceased or really retired. So you get all the swirly machine companies together, and you form a cute little monopoly there, a merger, tiny monopolies, but they're not really monopolies, they're just little mergers. So you can do little things like that, like magnifying glasses, what do you call them? I can't even come up with the name right now, but yeah, light bulb attachments that you turn on at night. What are those called? I don't use them very much, but yeah, flashlights, those. Yeah, so those types of companies, and typically those will be just here in America. So they would be kind of. There are going to be companies from self-made businessmen, mostly, where their children just didn't follow into the business. It was just them, and they were successful through their life, and that's that. And so instead, it's just like, oh, there was that great cookie company, you know, and they had that recipe, and where did it go? Where did the cookie company go? Well, maybe the kids just lived differently. They were allowed to live differently off the success of their parent, and yet when it came time to take over the business, they just didn't. So this is a little bit of a refinangling of going in back. And so get those cookie companies. So you have one, two, three or good cookie companies that went out of business, and you put them together and have, you know, those recipes again. So you can have those types of mergers. And so these are grim mergers. So we can actually go back 50 years at what was really amazing and what we lost. And it's just like, how did we lose that company? How did we lose it? Let's get it back. You know, because there are really good viable businesses that just went by the wayside, and yet we still may have features of them. We may have the machines, we may have the plans or whatever it was that was useful that made them successful. And so because you have those items and you group them together, we end up with a cute little conglomeration called a merger. And that means new hiring. And it doesn't have to be hiring of the family at all. The family doesn't even really have to participate. They just have to say, yeah, that's cool, and hand over the goods, the suppliers, blah, 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 all of those things they used. The family can get a small percentage, obviously, of income. Let's say your father invented Heineken. They could get a small percentage of Heineken years to go if they don't want to work in the company. You know what I'm saying? So that's the way it would be. So it's the family and heritage inherited businesses. They get a tiny percentage, and they don't have to work in it. And yet, they rehire. There is a rehire moment. We have to hire people into them. You know, get them back and viable. And I'm looking at younger people, people straight out of college, people in college, because yeah, college is very expensive. And I just filled out my college application, financial aid device there, and pretty much looks like 50% don't make it. 50% they get in there and they just drop out. So yeah, 50% of you are still smart enough though. The ones that didn't drop, that dropped out, they could be hired as apprentices for these types of businesses. So that's a good group you can look at, as well as the ones that actually did graduate. You know, because it's an expensive undertaking going to college. We all know that. So. So that's it. So the grim, we call those the grim mergers. And so, yeah, there's all kinds of funny little companies here in America that qualify. Usually sole proprietorships that made something really good, but their children just didn't follow up on it after. Now, why didn't the children? Usually, I'll say the children are slightly elitist. They benefited from the father's business, but they did not take it. You know, they didn't take the reins. And, you know, usually in these cases, many cases, it would be the father didn't want them to. You know, maybe very, very, what do we call that? Moguly. A moguly type. And so when they're moguly types, they don't really want their children, even their oldest son, to take over. So in these instances, it'll be those types of businesses. So yeah, so we can all, you know, we're thinking about the economy, where if it goes into a frazzle or a fizz, and we want a really good, strong business to bring back, you know, a business that, you know, when you're looking into business loans with the banks, you're looking at one that is going to be a sure thing, that's going to have a lower chance, a lower risk of a bank loan failure. It will be these types of businesses, because they were successful, they were tried, they were true, they lasted, you know, and you can even use the since, you know, in business since. You can use all of these demonstrative, wonderful things, you know, that sit on the label. You know, we've been in business since 150 years now, and we're the smartos still. So you can use all of these types of things, and so it makes that extra historical feature. Because I don't think we actually have very many historical businesses going on right now, and I why not? Why not make some more? It looks like we go back to 1800s. Was it the 1900s, where they had a lot of beer and a lot of these things that we brought in to into the 20th century, and they maintained throughout. So when we look at like drink companies and beer companies and those types of companies, they've been very, very good in the long term. But I believe from the 20th century, we have a lot already. Just basic good American weirdo things that we made, like magnifying glasses. All kinds of fun things. So any hoots, that's it. So yeah, the grim mergers. So a grim merger is essentially that you take three of these moguly type of business firms, even though they have folded, and you dig them up, from the past, and you remake them in a new fresh enlightenment time here with these young kids that are getting out of college, that are in college. Okay, so yay.